Good afternoon and happy Wednesday to all of your sunshiny faces. So guys, I actually got a lot of stuff done on my planner for today, pretty much just about everything. I still need to finalize my grocery list for tomorrow, but I did most of it. I just need to actually like add it to my my lists, and also do the see if there's anything to match up with any of the app rebates and stuff like that. But guys, I realized that I had told you guys I was gonna do my meal prep next week, and I forgot that on Wednesday it is my birthday, and so we're actually going out for dinner on over this weekend, but for my actual birthday, which is on Wednesday, I think we're just gonna like do pizza because we're going out to eat. Like I said, I don't know if it's gonna be on Sunday or Saturday or Sunday of this weekend. And then Thursday's Thanksgiving, so I have 2 days in there at least where I won't and don't need to do any meal prep. So yeah, I don't know what I was thinking, but the weekend following that I think is when I'm going to do my meal prep. I got my list partially made, my grocery list, but I realized I don't actually have to do any meal prep for this week. And then on top of that too, I did I gathered up all of the dirty laundry and organized it all and, you know, sorted it and everything like that. I didn't even have enough to do a full load of laundry yet, so I actually did that. I got dishes loaded up in the dishwasher, but again, I don't even have enough to run a full load of dishes today. So I'm like ahead of my game as far as like the dishes and laundry game goes, guys. And then I edited and uploaded yesterday's vlog, and then also I edited and uploaded the freezer dinner video. So I think this vlog that you guys are watching right now should be out on Friday, and the freezer dinner video should be out as well on Friday, I think. Maybe in the morning. I don't remember when I scheduled it for. But then I should have the blog post posted shortly after that and across all of my social medias. So, yeah, I got that stuff done too today, which the video to edit took me a little while, because I was actually playing with a whole bunch of different like elements and stuff like that. I was doing music, and I was adding in text in there too to go along with like the breakdown of the prices. So I need to start getting into a routine of how I'm doing that video, so that it can be easier, I think, when I start to do them like regularly, because I was like, oh, should I have the music at this volume or should I have it at this volume, and should I, you know, how should I do the text and stuff like that. And so then I was, you know, playing around with stuff, and it took me way longer than it normally would have if I was just knew what I was doing, but I didn't know how I wanted to do it. So that, and then on top of it too, took me a little while to edit because originally it was like 25 minutes long. I edited it down to like I think 14 minute long video, but it was also, there was footage in there that I ended up like speeding up and used in the like the fast speed, sped it up. And so I had to do that too, but then there was clips in there I had to cut out. So I got that done, but like I said, it took me quite a bit of time, and I ended up taking out like over 10 minutes of it, or shortening it down because it was, like I said, I sped up the clips. So I got that done too, and then I was watching the sports games tonight. The Bulls ended up losing, which I didn't actually watch them play. Then I watched the Hawks, which they ended up winning 1-0, guys, which is pretty amazing because they beat their, eight-game losing streak that I think they were on. And then I watched the NIU game, and they ended up losing, which the team that they played isn't in their, it's like in the other division of their conference, so I don't know if it counts as a conference loss or not. But Matthew was actually there at the game tonight, and he actually ended up winning $100 because they, for every, I think, 1,000 students that they have come into the stadium, because they use their like student pass, they get in for free. I think 10 of them or 100 of them, or 10 of them or something like that, I think, win $100. Matthew is one of those kids, and it was funny too because at the last home game that we were at, I asked him, I was like, oh, so like, you know, have you ever won, or did you know anyone that won yet? And he's like, oh no. But then he texted us tonight and said that he won, so I think they credit it to his like student account. So he won $100, which will go to books, you know, or something like that. I'm sure he's just gonna be like, using it for whatever, but like I said, it's a pretty like smart little incentive to get like the students to go to the game and stuff like that, and then also to you know, they get money back towards, you know, like things like books and stuff like that. So it's pretty cool, and he was pretty cool that he won. But guys, as far as Thanksgiving goes this weekend, the reason my list actually didn't take that long to make is because I don't think we are doing Thanksgiving dinner at home. I actually think we are going to get Boston Market, just because, guys, it has been like Thanksgiving, guys, seriously, we are 5 people, you know, if Matthew's girlfriend comes, 6 people, and all of us have different tastes for Thanksgiving. Everybody wants something different. This year too, my dad was saying how he doesn't want to carve the turkey because he just doesn't like doing it, and he was like, can we just get a turkey breast this year? So I did get a turkey breast, but I don't think that we're gonna actually have it on Thanksgiving. We'll probably save it for either like Christmas or, you know, some other day you can have turkey whenever, right? But he was just like, can we just get like a turkey breast instead of me having to carve the whole turkey? So yeah, because my mom doesn't do it and my dad is the one that always does it, and he was just, I don't know, just wanted to get a turkey breast. So that's what we ended up getting, but I don't think we're going to, because again, it's so much food that we have to cook and so many different trays of food that we have to cook for just 5-6 people is like crazy. Like, we end up having like literally everything that you'd have in a normal Thanksgiving dinner, but for 5 people. And so we try and make it a little bit smaller, but in some cases you can't always do that. Like, I don't know, we like lots of mashed potatoes, but again, like a turkey, we're only 5 people, and you know, 2 of us don't eat it. Well, I guess Matthew's girlfriend does eat turkey, but you know, 4 or 5 people that end up actually eating the turkey, and you know, but we're still getting like a full-size turkey that feeds like 8+ people. And that's not necessarily the case this year, but that, and then too, like we do like green bean casserole, and like for that you kind of have to use like a whole can of like cream of mushroom soup, and so you have to use this, you know, right amount of the green beans and stuff like that. And so that, and like too, my dad's really the only one that likes sweet potatoes, like mashed sweet potatoes, but we still wind up doing that, and like that could feed like 4 people though, because of the amount that like even just like one mashed potato practically has. And again, there's so much other food that it's like you could have a little bit of it, but it's not something that, again, like everybody else is eating, so we don't eat all of it. And we have so many leftovers every year. Most of the time is stuff that doesn't even wind up getting eaten, and I feel like a lot of times it winds up being not only a waste but so time consuming to, again, like do all of that. So my mom has suggested a few times now to do Boston Market. We were actually thinking about maybe doing, they have like homemade like Thanksgiving dinners that you can order like from grocery stores and stuff like that as well. I know Caputo's had one last year that I thought was like a smaller like 4-person meal, but this year they only have like an 8-to-12-person one, which is like $100 and something, which I was like, okay, at that price I might as well just, like, you know, my time isn't worth that much money. I'd rather just make it, and again, we're gonna have so many leftovers, so that doesn't seem to be worth it at all. Jewel, I think, might have one, but I think we're just kind of looking at Boston Market to do Thanksgiving dinner this year, because we do it every year for Christmas Eve. I almost said 4th of July, guys. I almost said New Year's Eve. For Christmas Eve, we do Boston Market every single year, and so my thought was like, you know, we do that, why not just do it for Thanksgiving too? And my mom had actually come up with the suggestion anyway, but it is kind of like our go-to like holiday food, I feel like, it's like Boston Market. So yeah, it honestly is weird, guys, too. We used to just like go to Boston Market more like when I was little, like near the holidays and stuff like that, like after we get done like going Christmas shopping, or after we get done like looking at Christmas lights, or there's this little like, it's kind of like a farm zoo-ish thing. It's more like farm animals, but they call it a zoo. It's not really, like I said, it's more like a farm, but they used to decorate like for, well, I guess they still do, but we used to go to it, we haven't like in a long time, but they decorate for like, you know, with Christmas lights and stuff like that, and we'd always go to Boston Market like afterwards because it wasn't too far away from there. And so like it was just kind of became like a tradition that we'd go near like the holidays and stuff like that, or like after we did something holiday related. And then I think it kind of morphed into a like almost now every single Christmas Eve. I was gonna say Thanksgiving Eve, guys, oh my gosh, I cannot speak at all, and I've literally said almost every single different different holiday for Christmas Eve now. But no, we used to go there, or it turned into a tradition, like, near Christmas Eve. I think, like, maybe only, like, since I've been in middle school or so, that we've really kind of been doing that. And so it's, again, kind of our just, like, it's got a lot of, like, I feel like comfort food and a lot of, like, you know, like, kind of traditional-ish, like, holiday-ish food, kind of. Like, they have mashed potatoes and, like, you can get, like, I don't know if you can get turkey, maybe you can, like, and, like, chicken and, meatloaf and stuff like that, just, like, kind of stuff that you'd make near the holidays also, but, like, mashed potatoes and, like, other, like, vegetables and, macaroni and cheese, if I didn't say that already, because it's my favorite. but, yeah, so they have, like, more, like, I feel like holiday kind of food, so that's why we always tend to go there, like, for our holidays and stuff like that. And, yeah, I don't, like I said, that sounds like it's what we're doing this year, and I hadn't made a grocery list based on getting anything for Thanksgiving. I mean, like I said, we have, like, the turkey breast, and, like, we kind of have stuff, I guess, for making, like, you know, other things, like green bean casserole, and we have potatoes for mashed potatoes, and, you know, my mom really wants to make, like, desserts still, I think. But, again, I'm not, I think I've told you guys this too, Thanksgiving's probably my least favorite holiday, and even I think I told you guys too, I don't like Christmas so much because of the food, but my least favorite holiday has to probably be Thanksgiving, because I just, it's a holiday dedicated to food almost, like, that's the whole point, that's, like, what makes Thanksgiving, and I don't think it necessarily should, but it, again, like, it's dedicated to food, and I don't really like any of the food that is served on Thanksgiving. I can't eat the turkey because I'm a vegetarian. I can't have gravy. I can't have, you know, 90% of the time I can't have the stuffing. Depending on what type of green beans are made, there might be bacon on them, and I think it's bacon. Is that what? Somebody has made that before, and I think I couldn't eat it because there was bacon on it. but, like, that kind of stuff, like, a lot of the food I can't eat, and then on what I can eat seems like it's all carbs, and it's like, I don't like IHOP for the same reason. I think I've told you guys that too, because I just don't like carbs. They're not, I like carbs, but at the same time too, I can't eat all of that for one sustainable meal. Like, I have to have something else, you know. Even if I do have carbs, like, for a snack or something like that, I have to balance it out. Like, when I have hummus and pretzel chips, or I'll have, like, if I eat something, then I'll have to have, like, some peanuts or some almonds or something like that, like, some type of protein to go along with it. So I always, like, mix that stuff in when I'm, like, eating or snacking or anything like that, that it has to be something else that has, like, some type of substance, because if not, I just am, like, super lethargic, and, like, on top of that too, I can't eat that much. Like, it seems like my eyes are always bigger than my stomach, is that the phrase? When it comes to carbs, I always get way too much, and then I'm like, I'm gonna be sick if I eat any more of this. And yeah, like I said, it's just, it's not my favorite, because I love, like, mashed potatoes are probably my favorite food, but I can't just eat mashed potatoes on Thanksgiving. And it's so close to my birthday too, that whenever we'd celebrate my birthday, it was always with Thanksgiving, you know, and so I never got to pick, like, I want this for my birthday dinner or something like that. Like, when we celebrated with family, it was always like, we have to have this, this, and this, and it was never like, what does Kayla want for her birthday dinner? No, it was always just Thanksgiving food, and so that's why I feel like over the years, especially when I was little, like, I've been resenting it every year. But if we do Boston Market, then I'll have something to look forward to. I'm truly thankful that we live near a Boston Market where we can have Boston Market for Thanksgiving. So, anyways though, guys, I will see you all in tomorrow's vlog. If you guys did enjoy today's, make sure you guys give it a big old thumbs up. If you guys are new, we'd love if you'd subscribe, and I'll see all of your sunshiny faces tomorrow. So, bye guys.